Welcome everyone. With me today is Kyle, and we're going to talk about what it takes to get started with the Rapyd APIs and how to make your first API call. Hello, Kyle.
Hey, Drew. Hey, everyone.
But first, before we do get started, I would like to take a minute and mention our online community. It's community.rapyd.net. There you can go to engage in conversation about our APIs or just fintech news in general. So highly would encourage you to go there and join the community. On top of that, after the video today, you'll be able to see in the description below several links that will give relevant information to what Kyle's going to be talking about, as well as timestamps that you can click on to go directly into the video to some pertinent points that might be relevant to exactly what you're looking to learn more about. So that said, enough banter from me. I'm going to turn it over to Kyle and let Kyle tell us how to get started using our Rapyd APIs. Take it away, Kyle.
Thanks, Drew. So we have our community and we have our documentation, and now we're going to walk through what it looks like to get started with your first API. We're here now on our Get Started page on our documentation, and you're just going to go to client login and click here, and that'll take you to the client login page. You'll click sign up, fill out that form. You'll be sent an email link, and then it'll take you back to the login page where you'll log in with your SMS verification code. And so we have our client portal here. This is our hub of basically all your accounts, your API calls, payments, disperse, and our platforms. We are going to go to the developers tab where you grab the sandbox credentials in which you can switch between sandbox and production. But we're making our call in Sandbox today. Going back to the first API call page here, we're going to be downloading a Postman collection, which you can use to make your API call. And it has all the headers and signatures for you set up. And so we're going to download the Postman collection here. I'm using Mac, so I'll download Postman for Mac and import it into the Rapyd workspace. Here, if you have a PC, you can use Postman for web, and that's basically using the Postman application right in the browser here, and it works. If you're not familiar with Postman, you can just go to postman.com/downloads and download the app. It's a great tool and resource for making API calls. Going back to the Postman native app that I'm in, here is a folder folders of all of our Rapyd platforms with the different API calls in each. What we're going to do is go to the sandbox environment. I do recommend a dedicated workspace so you have just a clean list of your environments. But if you are using a shared workspace, just search for or look for Rapyd Sandbox environment here. So what we're going to do is input the access key and secret key. Here, I'll grab the secret key. Grab the access key. And there we go. We are ready to make API calls and make our first API call now. So if you want to learn more about the Rapyd platforms, you could go here, Rapyd platforms, and it'll take you to link all of our products within the platforms and descriptions and lead you to the API calls there. I'm going to go to payment and payout method types. And this is the API call we're going to make today. Just list payout methods by country. And if you go through that link, it'll show all the parameters and the body response descriptions as well. And so I'm going to search up list. This payment method by country. And so what we're gonna do today is SG for Singapore. It uses the two country code, which you can actually search up by just list countries, API call. Here. But I'll hit send. And there we go. We've made our first API call. And here we have the different payout payment method types for Singapore all listed. And then your next API call could be get required fields for a specific payment method type. So if you wanted to grab a Singapore credit card or a different payment method type. And so I'm going to go back to finally where you can find also all the different payment methods is go to my account settings and payment methods. And here we have everything listed. You just search country SG, basically all of the Singapore payment method types that showed up in our API call are here as well.
Very cool.
And so there we have it. Here in Postman is where you can make all the rest of your API calls and start testing and building.
Nice. Really good, Kyle. Thanks for that.
Thanks, Drew.
So just one thing to add. I mean, Kyle and I are going to be doing a bunch of more videos like these. And some of the things that he went through in the beginning, like kind of around the client portal, you know, from a developer lens, we'll go into a deeper detail because some of the countries you may want to test our APIs and it's not available in your country. In the dropdown, you know, I mean, you can select a different country, one that's nearby, and go ahead and use this to test the APIs if you'd like. And, you know, as long as you're domiciled in the country, you can build for any country, right? So just go ahead, you know, if you want to play around with it, shoot us a question, you know, go to the community again. There's a list of all the available countries, but, you know, that list is growing constantly. So, you know, make a comment there, get engaged. And we'd be happy to talk to you more about that. And we definitely are looking forward to creating more videos that will tack on to this getting started with the first API call. So thanks. Really appreciate it, Kyle. So just in closing here, what I'd like to do is just take a minute and talk a little bit about, again, community. Community.rapyd.net. Get engaged. Join. Be part of the conversation. We have a lot of the things that, or everything really, that Kyle talked about today listed on our docs, which is docs.rapyd.net, which he referenced. And if you do have a question and you don't want to reach out through community, or you know, you're on Twitter and you're active, look for Rapyd Payments. Ask a question there. Kyle and I would be happy to answer it. Use the hashtag RapidBytes. And yeah, we hope you guys enjoyed the video, and we're looking forward to making more in the very near future. So yeah, thanks.